I've been working on Rex Quando all day as I get ready to interview Conor McGregor. Wait, it's Conor McGahey. I knew that didn't make sense. Bow to your sensei. Let's talk about this matchup because this is one that we loved last year in the playoffs. However, it's been very much one-sided. Let's start with Mikko Rantanen, outstanding for the Avs. He's the real deal. What's been some of the reaction in the room to what he's done this season so far?
First of all, wonderful Rex Quando reference, Tony. That was spectacular. And yeah, Conor McGregor and I are pretty much the same person. But as we move on to Mikko Rantanen, what I like about Mikko the most is, yes, he leads the league in points with 24, but he's on a line with Nathan MacKinnon and Gabriel Landeskog. That's no secret. The best part about Mikko Rantanen is the fact of just how humble he is. He doesn't want to talk about his performance. He wants to talk about his teammates. He wants to talk about what they can do better. And that's what makes a great line even better and a great player even better. The Avs knew exactly what they were getting in Mikko Rantanen when they drafted him where they did. 84 points last year. He's well on his way this year. And for Mikko Rantanen, everything is going his way. You see, he's averaging about 20 minutes time on ice per game. He played 24-44 in Vancouver on Friday, which is a career high for him, and also leads all players for the Colorado Avalanche so far this season. So Coach Bednar is not afraid to throw him out there in any type of situation. He's an all-around player, and he's exactly who exactly the type of player you want in your team at all times.
And even if he doesn't want to talk about himself, we'll keep talking plenty about him. We've talked a lot about Colorado's explosive top line. Jared Bednar, is he looking for more balanced scoring from his other lines?
Yeah, without a doubt. I think that's a league-wide issue as well, especially when you get like a team like Boston, their top line doing a lot of the heavy lifting as well. It's been a conversation in Edmonton over the years in Toronto. But you talk about a line here with the Colorado Avalanche that has done 58.3% of the scoring, and that's Landeskog, MacKinnon, and Rantanen. Everybody else, all other forwards that are not named those three guys, have only scored 45 points. So they want more out of guys like Alexander Kerfoot, 43 points a year ago. Carl Soderberg, 37 points a year ago. He's well on his way as well with the best start to his career. So depth of scoring was a talking point before the season began, and it remains that case now. You look at Kemenev and Drysdale, and they've been an important part of everything for the Colorado Avalanche. Sheldon Drysdale, of course, was sent down. He's been called back up, got his first career goal. We'll talk about that in a second. But it's efforts like that that are extremely important to the Avs, just in case the line of Landeskog, MacKinnon, and Rantanen go cold for a spell that we haven't quite seen just yet.
Conor McGahey, great having you on the show, and you do a great job broadcasting the games. I listened to you and really enjoyed it.
Thanks,
enjoy tonight's game.
Well, dude, Tony, thanks for having me on. Appreciate it.